think. Yeah. I'm starting to lose track with the episode description. Yeah, so if you remember, we got kind of invaded. It was an NPC that invaded us, but still invaded. This guy showed up. Master Kai. No, thank you. Leave him alone. So yeah. So we're going to meet a new character today, like I mentioned. He's more or less this game's version of Solaire. Are you all dead still? We're going to find out. Yes, you are. Good. Oh yeah, the giant rat disappears into a ring. Forgot about that. In fact, skin point 8. I didn't even look at this actual... Huh. I never actually looked at the actual ring itself for this thing. I didn't realize it was like a claw. That's cool looking. We got this one, increased bleed resistance, which I don't think we have to worry a whole lot about in this particular instance. It would have come in handy against Hodrick, the guy that invaded us, because he... I think the weapon he had was like a Flambergé. Because it looked like it had, like, ridges along the side of it. But whatever it was, it did cause bleeding, or had the potential to cause bleeding. So it would have been useful against him, but we didn't really have to worry about that a whole lot. Oh, buddy. I feel so bad for you. Alright, let's see if I can... Fall off the cliff! Aww. Sometimes I can get him to fall off the cliff, but that's usually only if I'm able to trigger them from a distance. Which I still need to get across. I need to start investing in a crossbow. This thing's really good. Oh wait, did he fall off? I think he did. Let's see, can we see him down there? Yes, we can. He fell off. That worked out well. Is this guy just over here just waiting to drop his soup on somebody? Let's see if we can't knock him off too. Let's see, just get ready. Oh no! Okay. Knocking off failed. Ooh! Hello! But I can't use you yet, but I'll be able to for me soon. This giant machete has a slash attack and is a worker's tool in the Undead Settlement. This dismantling tool was not originally intended for use in battle. Sharpen. Scrape the blade to sharpen and enable a cleaner cut. Let's take a look at you. Jeez. Oh, I can't roll with that let's see. Ooh, and now it's shiny. What if I... Yeah, I can't wield that worth a damn. That's cool, though. Where's Claymore? Here you are. The Baymore. Okay, that actually sounds like a cool name. Baymore? That sounds cool to me. Another one of those unkindled eye. Speaking of large weapons... I wouldn't say I deserve it, but... Heed my words. If you've any sense, you go find a coffin to huddle up inside. You near in this land of hollows. You're like a frail maiden on the front lines. How dare you! If like the others, you're fool enough to play the champion. Then go on ahead. Traces right past the abandoned church. You'll face death. And it won't be pretty. Enough death to leave you broken. Time after time.
Time after time. When you fall, I will catch you. You will find me.
Okay. So that guy's like the equivalent of the Dark Souls 2 opening, because he's just been like, you're gonna die a lot. That's most of his whole... Oh, wait, what's this? I was gonna take the elevator. Hey, buddy. How are you? We have the same sword? Do you have a claymore? Or do you know you have something different? What do you have, friend? Scintillating.
Oh, pardon me. I was absorbed in thought. I am Siegvert of Katarina.
Siegvert. I like the way he says his name.
Honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle.
Dill or sweet?
Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow?
Not yet, we haven't.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower. Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them. But I have to find a way up. And that's just the trouble. This lift only goes down, you see, and... Well, that doesn't get me anywhere.
Okay, Siegwerk, I'm going to teach you a trick that previous Dark Souls games have taught us, okay? Boom. How cool is this shit, Siegwerk? Later, buddy. Okay, which side is it on? This side. Okay. So we head up here. And if we had gone farther down the path that I mentioned yesterday, I could just take to get down to the boss, we would have seen this guy. So, this is a giant. He's got a giant bow, which I never actually noticed laying on the wall before. It's kind of a neat detail. He's got some giant arrows. It's giant everything. It's going to be from Texas, because everything's bigger in Texas. Okay. So let's just talk to him, you know?
Who are you?
And also notice the Balrog that's down there.
I am anytime.
So there we go. He gave me a little white branch, and that means that he shouldn't be firing on me from the raptors anymore. See, not everything in Dark Souls has to be resolved with fighting. Things can be nice. Not very often, but things can be nice. And we're gonna jump off here. Hey, you figured it out too.
Don't disappear like that. You had me downright worried. But thanks to you, an epiphany has struck me square in the head.
See, look at this. Look how nice this guy is. He barely even knows us, and he's worried about us. How nice is that? This guy is awesome.
On some days, I begin to doubt myself.
Don't we all, brother?
The tower, so I thought. Then somehow ended up here. I'm not exactly sure what happened. Anyhow, do you see that? That humongous beast?
You mean the flame nightmare that's down there?
I have a steady hand, but that thing makes my skin crawl.
I don't blame you.
How now? Think twice before you go down that road. I could try talking some sense into him. No, I think not. He's far too overheated.
But
I've got to use my head and think.
It's funny. Alright. Just gonna hop down here. Hop down here. We're gonna go fight this demon. Go fight this casual demon just walking around. A lot of place, buddy. Eventually. Hey. Oh, he sees us now.
No. You should have waited. Well, it's too late now.
You're damn right. This guy's like skin texture looks really cool. Yeah, he's coming to help. I have a feeling that's not what he wants. Oh, now he's mad. He is a mad demon now. Time to get away. Oh, those fire effects look so cool. Hey, Siegwerk, where are you? we almost got him. We almost got him. It's like Monster Hunter. Did you hurt my buddy? Yeah. Fire gem. That's the correct response, Siegward. Yeah.
That was quite a performance.
It went pretty well.
But you mustn't get in over your head.
I don't know, have you seen the things I've been fighting in this place?
But for the moment, we've a toast to make.
I got Siegbrow.
To your valor, my sword, and our victory together. Long may the sun shine.
Literally praise the sun. You know what? You know what? Where is it? I'm gonna get rid of this one. Yeah! There we go. You deserve the proper respect, Onion Bro.
I'm going to have myself a little nap. The only thing to do, really, after a nice toast.
It's true. He just cocks out. I love it. Okay. You sleep good, friend. See you next time. Okay. Is there any other items? I don't think there's any items over here. I don't know what this little, like, I guess it's to try to avoid the demon, but I don't know, he's not that bad. Of course, it helps I had some practice. Ooh, large club. Helps I had some practice fighting one of those things. In my other game, I was just going past into a certain area. Large wooden club requires considerable strength to wield. Characterized by savage leaping attacks, its weight makes it easier to break the guards of shields. Okay. So, okay, how large is it, I wonder? Let's see. It's pretty large! Eh, not very many savage leaping attacks. Oh well. That's a later thing. We won't get to for a while. And I got my armor set. Literally all of my armor. Yeah. It's neat. It's kind of neat that they do that, because they did a thing like that in Dark Souls 1, where apparently... Ooh, okay. That's creepy. Apparently, because you can find... all the different classes, like starting equipment in different places in the world, that's supposed to be the canon distance as to how far that character class went. So, for instance, there's a boss called the Gaping Dragon. That's one of my favorites. This guy's throwing poop at me. He's just throwing his excrement. Alright. Anyway. In the arena, you fight the Gaping Dragon, and you can find the warrior set for the beginning of the game in there. And so that's supposed to be how far the warrior got before he got, if you know what I mean. Stabby, stabby. Come on. Come on. Come on, Poochie. There we go. Good dog. Good dog indeed. Okay. That's the wrong thing. Really? You're just gonna let me... Okay, well, what if I do this? Hey! They fixed that issue! In Bloodborne, there was a thing where if you did something like that, you'd try to aim upwards with, like, a firebomb or something. For some reason, it would just collide with the ground behind you, and so it would just explode behind you without being actually thrown. There we go. Human pine resin. You know what? That's a good message. And let's see if one of these two old bats actually drops. Okay, they're not gonna let me just... Oh god. Ow. This is going great so far. Okay. So I guess bleed resistance would be useful because of these two. Or just other people of their enemy type. Oh god. Time to heal. I'm really glad I took care of those dogs out here. There we go, there's one. I shouldn't... Just try to attack me through the floor. Alright, I shouldn't have any problem dealing with the other one now that they're separated. Till death do you part. There we go. Silly mages. And neither of you dropped anything cool. You guys suck. I think one of my games I got one of their weapons, but I don't remember for sure. Either their weapon or one of their, like, weird giant coat things, whatever the hell you want to call those. I went the wrong way here. There we go. This is a ring, if I remember right. Yep, Flynn's ring. And this next part might be a little difficult. I might end up dying here. Just because of fall damage, I'm not able to really negate. We'll see. Okay. I hate trying to platform in Dark Souls. It's so finicky. Oh no. Yeah. I should have, yeah. Okay. It's fine. I can just run past everybody that I just fought and they won't chase me over there. How far back? Okay. This is doable. I'm just gonna have to do a lot of running. Because there actually is a ring that we want over there. They following me? Do they care? No, they don't care. Let's put an ember over here. That'll be useful later on. Okay. Excuse me. Aw, come on. Come on, lady. This is going not well. So that guy could actually probably kill me with... Okay, there we go. Oh, that went well. That was a good swing. Still didn't drop anything. You suck, lady. Okay, so we're gonna wanna just... Yeah. Insert Leroy Jenkins joke here. Or Yakety Sax, I'd be fine with either one. And that one might end up following me over quite a ways, but I don't think he'll actually get over all the way. See you later, sucker. Perfect. That went really well. What time is it? Where's my phone? Is it in my pocket? No, it's not. Where is it? I don't know how long the recording's been going. Crap. Where should I? Okay, whatever. Not a big deal. I'll just roll with it. Is Siegward still out here? Nope, he's gone. Alright. That's fine, I'm sure he's got stuff to do. Okay. Where am I going? I'm going this way. Serpentine. I don't care about that anymore because I got the item. I am probably going to kill these two dogs that are in here just because they can keep up with me. See, I say I'm going to kill them and then I miss them on every swing. I'm the best. I'm the best Dark Souls player. Vatividia wishes he was... Oh, no. Their range is always bigger than I think it is, even though I really should... I should be overestimating it instead of underestimating it. That staff of theirs is huge. Okay. Boom. Okay. Do this. Grab these. Thank you. Yeah, I bet that's how we died. Freaking. Hey, there we go. Okay, I don't think there's another. Yeah. So now we can just drop. Perfect. That went better. So I forgot about the armor set. I was more focused on the ring, which I probably can't wear. God damn it. You know what? I'm going to get rid of this for right now. This is more effective overall. Okay. So we got the Mira vest, which anybody that played Dark Souls 2 is going to recognize. Garb worn by Mira knights sent on journeys. This hard leather vest is bestowed only upon proven knights. Knights travel afar to fulfill their sacred duties, but few are ever able to deliver on their vows. Let's see, is that... How's that look? How's that look on me? That doesn't look bad, actually. I might keep that. And then, let's see. No. No. Back to the other helmet. But, if I keep that, I should be able. Equipment increases attack. Bleed resistance. Oh, that's different from what I thought it did. Just power attack, combat resistance, damage absorption. Well, that's not. There we go. I think I still look pretty hot, huh? See, I think there should be something back here. Or I could just think there's something back there, because that's how these games are, usually. How about this way? Nope. Okay, there's even less that way. Okay. So, we got that part settled. Now we can move forward and maybe get to the boss. Get wrecked, Poochie. So we want to go where the other dog is. We have to kill those rats again. Good trade. That's good trade. I'm the coolest. Yeah, we're going to have to kill those rats again. That's fine. Easy kills. Unless they horribly stun... Oh, no. See, unless they stunlock me. Alright, come on, guys. Yeah, I can see you in there. Yeah. That's what I thought. Okay. I'm not so much worried about Estes just because we're going to be going to a bonfire here in a second. Oh, although... I'm going to save my stamina real quick. Although I don't think I'll actually be able to get to him before he disappears. Oh, he didn't even move yet. Perfect. Oh, God. Woo! Hey, buddy. Don't you calm down there. Oh. It's like, alright, I'll leave you alone, I guess. And I had to throw a knife at his butt, and he's like, okay. It's great. Okay. And now he's back alive again. See, isn't that nice of me? Just evanescence you back to life here. He's still a little mad at me. God, why can't I get that moveset? Oh wait, I know, it's because he's a giant monstrosity and I am a weak little me. Alright. So notice these things sticking out of the ground. You're going to find out what those are here in a second. Oh no, a bunch of farmer, evil farmer dudes. What am I going to do? Go-ha-luck. Oh! It's our friend, Mr. Giant. With arrows that have a ridiculous arc to them. Get wrecked. Fading Soul, Ember, Young White Branch, Young White Branch, Young White Branch. Okay, we're gonna jump across here. And important item. That is gonna power up our Estus Flask. Not necessarily the number of uses, but in the strength of those uses. Reinforced Glove, also good. Let's just check out around here real quick. Worker Garb. Which I think I already have like three of. I would get all the shitty equipment and not any of the actual stuff that I would want. Like the unique stuff. Now if you could drop your weapon. Oh, I almost thought he did. Damn it. Oh well. I got an armor set, which I don't think I'm going to end up wearing. Oh yeah, this is the armor set for the cleric, one of the starting classes of this game. Garb worn by a cleric turned undead, unmistakable vibrant blue robes. It is said that the blue robe travelers were entrusted with a duty. They bore large covers on their backs to ensure they would not become seedbeds for spreading darkness. Man, the clerics get all this cool stuff. Why don't we get anything? What's nature yet to be revealed? Okay. I believe we also, unless this is it right here. Nope, there it is. Okay. Mortician's Ashes. That we can give that to the merchant lady that's in Firelink, and she will have new stuff to sell us. Take care of you. Not fond of Mr. Red Eyes there. And so how can we get over there? There's nothing connecting. Oh, wait. Kablamzos. Yeah! I love scythes. Too bad it's a dex weapon, but still. I guess technically I could make it a strength weapon if I had a heavy gem, which I don't think I do. Do I? I have raw, I have refined. Nope. No heavy gems. Yet, anyway. I'm sure I'll get one somewhere. Alright. If only I had a luring it out. Okay, then. Open this up. And shortcut. It's like a big figure eight between that shortcut and this one. So let's see, who's this? Is this a Sunbro? Is this a cooperator? That's pretty self-explanatory. We're gonna leave you though. We don't actually need you. We shouldn't. Giant ahead. Now this is going to be one of those things that I kind of wish hadn't been spoiled in, like, trailer footage. But that's just me. Just take care of these. Oh, okay, well. Started this earlier than I would have liked to, but oh well. At least I can kill all these guys in one hit. Except for any more red-eyed ones. Or, you know, they get their attacks out before I do. We're just gonna go up. We're gonna go up and smack his weird dick crotch thing. Maybe. He reveals it to us. Yep. Oh! My balls! What have you done to my seedlings? Whoop. And into part two. Which is still going to be difficult because it's awkward to hit some of these things sometimes. I've never really had any problems beating this guy, so I shouldn't need to call in help or anything. I just gotta watch out for that big hand of his. It's also just really kind of hard to tell where I'm gonna be able to hit him at. Unless he does this, which I don't think that actually hit where I meant it to. I did that. Yeah, you see what I mean? Oh, that one hit. Oh. Time to get out. Time to peace out. Now, plus I'm destroying these little things with, like, two hits. Assuming I can hit them. It's very finicky about where you can hit those things at. Now, granted, if I wanted to, I could go after that big arm. But I honestly like to keep my distance from that thing. For many reasons. Time to move back. There we go. Okay, we got this. We got this. Gary Gooley's got this covered, no problem. Eventually. Oh god, this is gonna hurt. I don't think it'll kill me. No, it won't. Yeah, that's why it would've killed me. Because it would've freaking comboed me. Yeah, so you can attack his hand, and it's more vulnerable than most other parts of him. But usually you want to go for those for the big damage. That's what I call big damage. And now I can't find any more of them. So if you do get to that point where you really can't find any more of those spots to attack, or they're just not letting you hit them, there we go. Bingo. Alright. It's a cool boss fight, but when you get to a point where it just physically won't let you actually aim at the parts that it's vulnerable, I just get a little annoying. Let's see, got a homeward bone. Got a war god wooden shield. And this thing. Which, sure, why not? Which is a thing for a covenant that we were not able to get to. But that's fine. I don't really understand. On my other game, I'm able to get into that covenant, but I don't totally understand what the point is. Because it's really similar to another covenant that we already do have access to. That's usually like the PvP covenant. But whatever. So we'll head to Firelink, and then that'll be it for this episode after I do a couple things. Okay. I feel like those load times got better than they usually were. Oh, let's take a look. Did we ever look at this? Yeah, we did, because it didn't have anything really go... didn't have much to it. So we got Soul of the Rotted Greatwood. Soul of the Cursed Rotted Greatwood. One of the twisted souls steeped in strength. Ever since its establishment, all manner of curses have managed to seep into the undead settlement. The worst of them were sealed away inside a spirit tree, but eventually the curses took their toll. I don't know why, but I like that. I like that description a lot. Oh, we also picked up somewhere. Where is it? This thing. Which I don't totally... See, it doesn't look like a physical item to me. It just looks like a black hole, basically. An old transposing kiln from Courland, crafted with stitched crystal lizard hide. Give it to Ludleth, Lord of Cinder, to conduct soul transposition. This kiln could transpose twisted souls to craft special items with their concentrated essence, deemed forbidden by those unable to make proper use of it. That seems like the saltiest thing ever. Like, I can't figure out how to use this. It just sucks. It's broken. No one else can use it. You don't have feet. You're just here because you can't physically go anywhere else. We're going to give you this. Okay, so basically what he can do is he is your boss weapon guy. So we can't do any either of these yet. We haven't seen an actual demon that gave its soul for whatever reason. We could make the Hollow Slayer Greatsword, which that's not bad. More of a dex weapon, so it's not really very much up our alley for this particular character. Could make Bort's Great Hammer, this big old mace. Anchor Weapon in Earth. Okay, so its main thing is that it can make create frostbite, which can do damage and slow stamina recovery. That's pretty interesting. It can make the Arster Spear with the soul with the great the tree's soul. It's a big defeating foes restores HP. It wreathed in heavily rotten poisonous meat. Blah! Let's not do that. That's also a dex weapon, which I wouldn't be able to wield any of these anyway. However, Pontiff's Left Eye. So whenever I attack, or whenever I attack successively, then I get HP back. So I'm going to go ahead and make this with Bort's Soul. And since neither of these are ones that we're going to really want to use, we're going to go ahead and jump down here. And we're going to use this one. Bam. And it's not worth a terrible amount. But, you know, still. 3,000. That's probably like a level at this moment. We're going to give you this. Okay. You give us new stuff. And there's a key. We're going to buy that key. That's an important key. Excuse me. And that is everything we really need from her right now. So, thank you. I don't think we have enough Titanite to improve the Baymore anymore. We do not. We have no Titanite. Can't do that either. Need to repair anything? No. Infuse. Find raw. Yeah, can't do much right now. Alright. Okay. So if that's the case, what we can do is we can take that undead bone shard. Bam. Estus Flask plus one. And I think the flame should start going up a little bit higher in there. Just a little bit, though. Not that much. And finally, get this going. Let's see. We're going to up vitality a couple bits. Make this a nice even 20, 18, 17. Okay. All right, there we go. And before I forget,
Bam. All right. So, that'll be it for this episode. Next time we'll be going into a new zone, and we're going to go meet, another character. We were fairly close to her originally, but we couldn't get to her just yet, but now that I have that key, we're going to go get her. And we should be getting into a new zone, seeing some new enemy types. And so I will see you tomorrow at 7? Yeah. Yep. Tomorrow at 7 for part 5, I believe. So until then, have a good day. And I'm glad you enjoyed watching. And I'll see you later. Bye-bye.